I've only really been playing this deck for a little while. Like, I had blue black control, and it was just, I mean, people were too prepared for it, so I went over to this deck. And I can't help it, I'm a red blue green player. I'm on the draw. I think I can keep this hand. As long as, like, if he has a turn two mana leak, that would kind of suck. But, like, turn two Cobra, turn three Cobra, Oracle Madaio, really. Turn two Cobra, turn three Oracle Madaio. If he represents mana leak mana, then more than likely I'll just do this. Thank you, Raging Ravine, to make it look like I'm not just playing around mana leak. Okay, that's actually perfectly acceptable. Because now I can double Cobra Snake Eyes. Yeah, playing the second Cobra is still probably the better option because, like, he can't really do much to stop it other than, like, Day of Judgment. And that's, I think I'm okay with him using a Day of Judgment on Cobras instead. And if he also, like, he also has to think about Tectonic Edge on Raging Ravine. Think he's looking for Day of Judgment. Or for a second Wall of Omens. A second Wall of Omens could mess things up a little bit. Let's see here. If I attack, then he doesn't kill Raging Ravine. He won't kill Luke. He won't kill either of the Cobras. Yeah, it looks like attacking Balerion right now is the best I can do. Or I'll attack him. Like, in this case, like, it's like I he if he uses the last Jace, if he uses Jace's to draw him a card and then play Jace, then, like, all I really did was kind of like stop him from drawing one card and gain him to life. So my question is, okay, 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna keep blue open. Oh no, like, not really much I can do on problem with blue. I should have led with Explore, expecting that. That was a pretty big screw up. So now he's gonna play another Jace. Oh, see, Oracle. So now my Cobras definitely can't attack. kind of need to draw land. That was another reason to play explore first. Kind of sucks. At this point, I want him to use that tectonic edge. But I also kind of want to preordain. And it goes to the bottom, keep that on top. And I want to be attacking. Yeah, okay. The whole idea is that I can basically gain 6 blue, or like 5 blue. That's probably a pretty good thing to take. Pretty sure I'm gonna steal that. And then have negate open. Let's see. Three. So this will create 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I can do this, have negate left, and then probably pay for mana leak. Sometimes it's pretty good. Okay. Actually, I may be able to place okay, if I get it back, I'll get another 5. So, yeah, I could definitely play Infernal Titan this turn as well. Does not have haste. Yeah, okay. Probably still just I'll explore because I can't pay for mana leak anyway. So probably just a little better if I give myself like an extra draw. Why did I keep thinking it gave haste? Might have been like on one of the spoilers that it was incorrect in a sense. Okay. See Oracle. Day of Judgment. It's probably gonna get Brutal Effigy. In which case, I still want to negate that. Negate that. The point being, like, I can do a lot, but I can't do a lot about that. Okay, is there anything I would want to preordain into? I think at this point, it's probably just better for me to play Infernal Titan. Make five. I think I can still activate one of the Raging Ravines. Five, six. Yeah, could activate one of the ravines. Okay. I'm gonna go for Island because should have two if I draw Jason after he Day of Judgments. Like, why is he making so much red? Trinket Mage is dead. Yes, I do want to redirect to Barrowloot. Blaring. Blah. Tap for red. Do-do.